There's a couple things that are contributing to the rapid increase of electric vehicles over the past few years. And I think the growth will continue over the next decade. One is electric battery technology. Lithium-ion batteries are far superior to what they were a couple decades ago. The other is environmental responsibility. So there's obviously a big emphasis now on sustainability and resilience, and the ability to reduce greenhouse gas emissions, which is a key component of what EVs can do. When we talk about planning to transition a fleet from gas to battery electric, one of the big things to start with is goals and objectives. So the big picture view, how many vehicles are we going to transition, and what is the site going to need to do to support those vehicles from an infrastructure standpoint and from a power standpoint? Moving past that, vehicle operation dynamics come into play. So we'll look at things like vehicle miles traveled, idle time, longest trip duration, and evaluating all of those things at kind of a total level allows us to get a good indication of what type of charging, how many chargers, and really the power of those chargers. Typically, the larger upfront costs we have in more infrastructure, it will offset and allow a lower operating cost over the life of the vehicle. Planning is very important because of the time element, especially now with longer lead times in the supply chain and some shortages in the global market. When you think about the upfront cost, electric vehicles are more expensive than their standard internal combustion engine counterparts. Over the life of the vehicle, when you start to think about the fueling costs and maintenance costs, there's a huge potential that electric vehicles will offset that initial purchase price within a couple of years of purchase.